Hillary Clinton apparently not ready to let go of her dream job. In an interview over the weekend, she was asked about running for president. Guess what she said?
Do you want to run again?
No.
Wait.
No.
That was a pause.
Well, I'd like to be president.
Okay.
But if she doesn't run, Democrats may have another interesting option. Anti-Trump attorney Michael Avenatti. According to a new political report titled Avenatti Quietly Builds a 2020 Machine, he has a team of veteran Democratic advisors, some of which are Clintonites, by the way, helping him plan a presidential campaign. It'll start. He'll make a decision by January 1st. But let's start with Hillary Clinton. What did she mean by that, Dana?
Well, it's like travel, how you... I like to be in places. I don't like to travel to places. So she would like to be president.
I can help you
without.
With that.
I know you have that idea.
Yes.
She'd like to be president, but she doesn't have to go through the. She doesn't want to go through the difficulty of running for president.
Can I add to that and interrupt?
Yes.
She doesn't want to run, but she wanted to be president. So essentially 2016.
Yes, exactly.
No. So this is the ultimate arrogance. She's saying like, you know what? Just make me president.
Right. It was her turn.
Yes.
That was one of the knocks on it. But also, if you look at somebody like a McCain or a Romney, they lost. Okay, McCain decided to run for re-election in the Senate. Romney, he lost the presidency, took some time off, and he decided, I still want to serve, so he's running for Senate. He'll be the next senator.
What about Al Gore? Hey, I lost a heartbreaker, and I'm it. That's it.
But the other thing is, every time she does this, it prevents somebody else from being able to emerge.
Absolutely. And here's the thing. She's on
Avenatti.
Tell me if this sounds familiar, Juan Williams. Gosh. She's going to be on a 13-stop listening tour or speaking tour with her husband. That sounds a lot like, I might run for Senate. I'm going to take a tour with Pat Moynihan and just go on a listening tour and find out what the people of New York State want. And don't give them that, but that's a side note. But this sounds like she's laying the groundwork for another run.
I think your fantasies are out of control on this Monday.
What about you? What do you think?
No, she's not. She clearly said she's not running, but she said... And I thought it was an expression of truth that she wishes she was president. She wishes Donald Trump had lost. I mean, that's the truth.
But you know, too, that she also said she wasn't going to run when she was Secretary of State and was asked on the Sunday show.
That's more run-up. But, I mean, the situation has changed. I am curious about Avenatti.
Right.
Because I just don't see how he... I mean, Avenatti got in trouble last week for saying it has to be a strong white male to take on Donald Trump. But you know what? He thinks he's the strong white male.
How do you feel about that, Greg? Avenatti running. He says, I'll decide by January 1st. He's putting a team together. He only owes $4.3 million and has an ex-wife that wants $200,000 a month.
Could he be their Trump? Could he be the out of nowhere, you know, dark horse? I'm going to say no, because I don't think he has any talent. He fashions himself as a bare-knuckled brawler, but when he gets out into the street, he loses every fight. Every single fight he loses.
Well, Lisa. Exactly. He's not clever or interesting enough to be 2020's President Trump. But look, regarding Hillary, Greg is absolutely right. She is entitled, and this is what it speaks to. I don't think she actually likes campaigning. I don't think she actually likes being among people. If you go back, even remember in 2015 when her and Huma went into the Chipotle and they had sunglasses on and they couldn't be bothered to talk to anyone. I think that was her problem all along. And I actually wrote a column about this in 2014 for FoxNews.com saying that she was going to be 2016's Mitt Romney. In the sense, like, just Mitt Romney, he was, even though he's a really good guy and we all know that and he's a good person, he just had this inability to connect with voters and be among the people.
Lisa,
and Hillary Clinton had the exact same problem.
More of a staffer. Put her Secretary of State, Secretary of Commerce, but don't make her run for that position. Let me ask you, on Avenatti, Dana, is it true or false? Right now, they kind of like the fact that he took on Trump and had some early victories, but these Democrats are going to turn on him quickly,
I don't think Democrats think much of Avenatti. Yeah, they might have liked that for a while, but I think that they recognize the dangers of it. We've talked in the commercial break about the problems that DNC has right now, that they are looking at the possibility of 30 candidates or maybe 35 candidates that think that they could all be president of the United States. They have much bigger problems than just worrying about Avenatti. But I do think it's pretty interesting. He's already hired staff, like Democratic staff.
These are established
and
people.
The Democrats, I mean, they're very good at cutting people off for other opportunities. They should probably deploy.
Get rid of him. He's
but,
mad.
But I'm telling
you. You know what this is, Brian? This is part of the fact that American politics is not your daddy's American politics, and that people are now looking for someone who is a, what would you call it, an alley fighter, backyard...
You don't like Avenatti, do you?
No, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. But I think that if you said, what is the positive about Avenatti, Lisa?
Nothing.
You would say, oh, this guy he'll get up and he'll get in Trump's face. Remember Biden saying,
"Oh, he loses." I'll take... To Greg's point,
what?
I said he loses.
I don't know, but
Trump
I'm saying
wins.
What you want is somebody who is as bellicose, as bullying as Donald Trump.
I don't think so, Greg. I think the winner of this. Tell me what you think of this theory, and don't be afraid to agree with me. I know it's a weird place for you to be. I believe the person, the person that runs successfully against Trump does not fight him, compliments on things he's done, say I would have done things different, because Trump is not great if you don't put your
You're
chin
nice
out.
To him.
If you don't put your chin out, he doesn't really hit you. If you come out and just respect what he's done but say, I don't like the tone, he might be or she might be successful.
So that was basically a long-winded opinion fashioned as a question. you were just telling everybody what you thought.
Tell me what you think. What do you think of my theory?
Honestly, I zoned out. I'm thinking about ribs. It's
5:42. But it's not Tuesday.
No, I'm looking forward to Chinese ribs.
Okay.
Extra sauce.
That sounds delicious.
Yes.
You had a chance to agree with me and change the narrative.
Exactly.
No, Brian, I feel for you, because normally he goes after me, but that was a low shot at my man, Brian.
I'm worried about his ADD. He couldn't stay with three sentences.